Well, I think we have a strong union, but I hope to bring about a new labor movement where the folks that make the decisions regarding schools in the state of Maryland will now have to listen to our educators. The voice of educators has been missing from the decision-making process, and I hope to bring that back to light.
Just recently, and just as recently as this year, there was legislation to put a teacher on the State Board of Education. That's something the MSEA backed. The bill did not pass, as far as I recall. Or I think Governor Hogan vetoed it.
Governor Hogan vetoed it.
Mm-hmm. What do you say to change his mind, or do you basically advocate for Ben Jealous to get this passed?
Well, obviously, we are supporting Ben Jealous in the upcoming campaign, and it is unfortunate that Governor Hogan has never spoken to us at MSEA. And again, you referenced the bill. It's critical to have practitioners on the state board that is making decisions for every school system. I sit at those meetings, and oftentimes I hear the discussion and think an educator would be able to provide that firsthand knowledge, and they're missing that. So it's unfortunate that it was a bipartisan bill passed by the General Assembly that he vetoed.
And yet you don't have that on the local level. For example, Baltimore County, as far as I know, there are no current teachers on the board.
There currently, but there are several running,
right,
and we are supporting those educators that are running for the Board of Education, because we see more and more, just as we have doctors who have a board, doctors have input.
Sure.
So we want educators to have input in the decisions for our schools.
Another issue that has come raising teachers unions and all public service unions is the Janus decision that was issued by the Supreme Court before the term ended. And it basically ends the mandatory dues, and that people can be waived from mandatory dues if they disagree with the political activity. A group has been sending emails to teachers, mainly in Baltimore City, involving them of their options. The MSEA, I know, is opposed to that. What do you have to say on that issue?
Mark Janus, the person who was part of the Supreme Court, was funded by Betsy DeVos and other big corporations and Right to Work, and has since left his job to go work for them. So this has been an all-out assault on labor unions, especially those in education. And we see the need for a strong union, for a strong middle class. And so, you know, Betsy DeVos, Governor Hogan have all tried to take money from public schools and put that into private schools, vouchers, and we are the roadblock. And so Koch brothers, other corporations are all coming after us, but we feel strong here in the state of Maryland.
But at the same time, if I'm a teacher and I disagree with the union's position on, you know, a political candidate or any other issue, but I like, you know, I know the need to be in a union to get the benefits and the collective bargaining rights, you know, I support that, but I don't support them politically. What options do I have? Why shouldn't I have the options to at least withhold part of my dues?
Well,
there
is a misnomer, because currently dues dollars do not go to campaigns. It's a voluntary contribution that our members make to fund campaigns or support candidates. So currently members, and I've been a member for 30 years, our money that we pay to dues goes to help our rights and have a collective voice. So there has been some misinformation that has been shared. And we will, again, go out and reach those folks. But we've been doing polling, and overwhelmingly, our members and supporters feel that we have a strong union, and they want to be part of that strong union.
Is it tough to attract younger members, you know, to convince younger members of the need for union membership?
Not for the need for union membership, but
right,
we're working on those to keep younger members to stay in the profession longer than just a couple of years.
Yeah. Is that still one of the biggest challenges, is teacher shortages, where young people might teach for a few years after college and then go into another profession where, quite honestly, they could make more money?
It is an issue, and that's why we're looking to the Kerwin Commission and the state legislature to help us raise teacher salaries and educator salaries for the living wage. Because too often our folks are working 2 and 3 jobs, and when people are coming out of college, that doesn't interest them. So making it more of a professional pay commensurate to other people who have the same level of education is critical in this state, so that we can put the best educators in front of our students.
Cheryl Bost will serve a 3-year term as the MSEA president and can run for another one in 3 years if she chooses to do that. Cheryl Bost, the new president of the MSEA, thanks for joining us on WBAL. We appreciate it.
Thank you.